This is Musei Timonio Lek, father of the deceased.
Timon Lufumo Owe Mautikaya.
The Laganda Hamlet is saying,
Ye Lok Magawade Kil Muganda.
They say, Pasima Ogende. Which means they appreciate you when you are born.
I don't
know where they take it from up in Nigeria.
Yes.
Kifui in Ita.
Kifui
in Ita.
Huh? Kifui? No Ita.
Kifui? No Ita. No Ita. Yes. Kifui no Ita.
So let's
ask the
with
our children.
Do you appreciate when you are born?
Kitika koine, not a
But
if
you
are doing
better,
to appreciate
when you are around.
When you are better, you are better. You are better. You are better.
You
are better. You are better. You are better. You are better. You are better.
You are Now, they happened. They were not necessary, but they happened. At least the least we can do is understand those mistakes. And undertake to not repeat them.
We are not going to be able to do it.
This time they went on until now, you were to send me this hand about the Joseph this
time.
Deep in Africa, far away from where they came. And yet the enemy was in Palestine. Oshara was also the head political here in Ikulu.
The one, the kid will be a move with the Arab woman in the
land. Because of speaking the truth, the castle is dead, police dead.
The local of Ada, one of the people who will be with the
Arab. When you are not agreeing to the wrong line,
the end of the deal to Arab, the ticket back will come, go.
You are being pushed wrong here.
Go for man, okay, why they can pay time with the Arab, the
car. Never.
So man, le moi, hours. Now I'm going to talk to you. You can make it
Why
do
you talk about the
whole
of Uganda?
Because I want to talk about Uganda,
but those who are opposing that line, they are being blacklisted. You're not good.
You're not good.
But that struggle went on.
And on the other hand,
at the different fronts,
he took bullying in the Papa.
First of all, in the army, physically fighting those killers. But also at the political level. Now, in the last concluded election of 2011, that's something the regular restriction
was
talking about. The people of Uganda voted together. That's why we had people standing on the same side. Majority in the north, majority in the east.
Which was the line of Oshara.
Oshara was one of the young people whom I sent to Monuri.
That this channel which are Arabic became the thing of man of the thing of my end with this global Italia can the Mukunye come to Monuri.
When I was in the Ministry of Defense.
I don't know whether he went in
1979 or 1980. When did the people came back? They are the ones who they sent to fight me when I was in the world. Who are some of them?
No, we are any of Bulu, Makungi, or two. Bule, Bule, get up the car, make a way for another anti you know.
When you are a civilian, you can deceive yourself.
Can you mean it in real? No, you don't become a little day.
But in the army, you are more actually from not throwing the truth.
And so you would, that was not the level of the world, but for making it, the only thing you might.
There are these young men who were in the army, they were able to see everything for themselves.
So, I will be a long area for you to be people in the morning and go out with more of the government.
And come to conclusions. So say, it's the right, it's the wrong.
We are not going to be able to do it.
The moment they came to the conclusion that this was the wrong line, the right line, we came together. Of course, we are trying to come to the 1979. Of nationalism.
Ne Wagala, again, we don't know where.
Then where is Uganda?
Where is Uganda?
So,
if you
have translations for me properly.
Small time.
Now, he has died. the other night when the nationalist forces are gaining the upper hand.
In the whole of Uganda.
You heard what the honorable people here told you. In 1962, Uganda was under Kabaka Yeka.
Buganda was under the Lord Kajuli.
Busoga and Lango.
Ilao ki Busoga unutiju PC.
So, there was no force which could unite Uganda.
Si karemu, jimnarigu Uganda, dokuze, el ngang mante, jilwe mafasa.
And we started on a wrong foot from the beginning. And it did not get wrong for the whole thing
to
collapse. By 1966, just 4 years from independence,
the whole thing
had collapsed.
The
Bible is very rich with this.
It says
whatever man sows, that's what he reaps. So, that's what the Ugandans sow, that's what they reap. They sow division, hatred, greed. And they reaped all these problems which I saw here the Psalm 23 that I saw it here in this booklet. The talks of the shadow of darkness. Stand here on behalf of the government and on behalf of the NRM to salute the contribution of this young man. Who is the young man? 54 years, he was young. And these were the young people whom we were bringing up. In this short time of his life, through his own experience, because he was in the army, he was able to see through practice, what was right and what was wrong. Which of course coincided with our own position, because we had been putting this one out all around. So I come here to salute his contribution. And to assure his family that we shall stand with them. The UPDF is a new big fight in Uganda, since you are into fights. There is a new powerful tribe called UPDF. I don't think I should call it a tribe. I think we should call it a new force. Let's call it a new force. This new force called UPDF doesn't care about your tribe, doesn't care about your religion. And this is becoming a big force. We're just like brothers and sisters and sons and sons.
Le terrain.
I happen to be some sort of grandfather in that force.
Donc un douleur, mais un déterroir. Donc je m'en ai dit que j'ai un déterroir, on dit que nous. A qui j'ai m'en fait de vous dire, mais...
So...
Donc, non, non.
The children of Ochoa are my grandchildren.
Donc le terrain, par les cas de votre Ochoa, nous n'avons pas aimé.
And all the family of UPDF, that's how we look at each other.
Qui douleur. Le UPDF a envoyé même le fait d'avoir rien avec elle.
So we shall stand with them.
Au but d'une poignée.
It was a pity that he died.
Au fait de vous m'arrêter, n'est-ce pas au rain.
Because definitely he was going to be useful.
Et encore pour le rouler, poignée, vous verrez dire tout ça, quand.
If you, the people who lived in 20 before us, we had more use for you.
But we have to look at the UPDF, we have to look at the UPDF, and we have to look at the UPDF.
If you were disappointed because of that and it affected him, then it was unfortunate because it was not necessary.
Prepare to hear the message.
Thank you. What has been assessed?
Let us pray. Wendigo, Wendigo, Daro, Madawa Nuado, Nir Merenda, Pupongi Chan, and we Matana Tura Dom, Dom Nay, Yuwa Matana Tibu, Peri Manach. If you want, what did you talk? Wabi Yuwa Gibara Nga, Korobore, I would. May one have a little bit of a
Amen.
Sustain the freedom and the peace that is worked for. It is easy to have achieved it, but it's going to be challenging to maintain it, especially when pioneers.
Fortman Mamine, Elio Mio, Puti, Kumba, Nishaka, Mukara, and Pio, Perua, and Matin.
This thanks is because of the life is bestowed on us from the beginning up to now.
Kimberly, Mirami, a mate for chair, Pierre, and Matini, Washiki, and Isama Deep, Mao Shaw, and my papa, Ma.
We also thank him for this congregation and the church that has been built here. All you mourners, brothers, you constitute a congregation who have come to escort myself. Also want to thank our big father, our grandfather, the president who has joined us in this funeral service. I thank all the religious leaders who are with us here today. I pray that should be the voice of the Lord that should come here, not ours. I don't have a lot to say about this problem. His life history has already been told. I have only two things to say. To add on what has been said about the life of Walter Chora. I want to inform you that the courage that Ochora had, he never learnt it from any school. His courage he was born with. Nobody can learn how to be courageous in the classroom. Courage is inborn, flows from blood. Those of us left behind only have one cry to make. The gap created by him, we have no capacity to fill it now. The gap he has dug is so deep in this little clan that we live in. He was giving all kinds of assistance to this clan. We are not really mourning Ochora, but we are crying for this gap. Who will feel it for us? We are praying to God that this gap that has been created should be filled, because all our children are outside.
You
are. I don't know
how
I don't want to take a lot of time for today. I am the father of Ochora. His real father was elder to me in Bath. I followed him.
Friends, relatives, and fellow mourners.
Lurem, Lukumu, Wari, or Kilurem.
I once again welcome you to this place. And greet you in the name of the Lord.
Muru, Inying, God bless you.
Allow me to say a few words on behalf of the bereaved family.
Dad,
I normally refer to him as Jose, so you excuse me.
Wonge chalo kanol Walter Ochora and machalo wede madit no ene nuone Jose.
Jose was a family man.
Wonge uno dama maro
gagné.
Irrespective of his line of work.
Although
he had a busy schedule, he had to squeeze the time for the family. He treated everyone like family, not only his inner family. Everyone was family. We shall forever cherish and miss that as a family. Mzee has left a very big gap. Not only in the family, but also in his line of work. Because getting a gentleman of this character, the way it is life, people fighting me, fight back, something unique, I always ask myself. It's one day I ask Dad, I said, Dad, I don't understand you. He just laughed it off and said, one day you'll find it out. But with today's number of mourners we have here, I think I've got the answer. And that's you. Unity among us. That's the only way to go forward. Not to waste much time, half for half, my sisters and brothers to talk. Let me wind up. Dad had dreams and goals for the family, as any other father. He loved farming so much, passionately. He loved farming, he encouraged the public. Farming, he did it himself. He has a farm, a very big farm. And besides that, he had other projects on the site. As earlier I mentioned, he was a pillar in our family. He was a sole provider. And now that he's not there, this is indeed a big challenge to the family. But with your prayers, with you on our side, I believe we shall make it and make him proud.
And
Your Excellency, the President, on behalf of the bereaved family, we request to have an audience with you at your own appropriate time and day, so that we can forward some of our humble requests. We shall dearly appreciate if you offer us this plate. I appreciate. May his soul rest in peace.
Can you hear the chairman? Just until May, not Parker last. Mr. President, fellow mourners, Gulu District Local Government Council already honored our brother yesterday.
Ladit won kom ubiung kain wajina da en kriti won kom wedwema beach kenyero temoga moji biero biero pare en mer kriti won kom wedwema beach wajoni Gulu District Chalo Council donku mi warge ho bonyele retired colonel Walter Otuarabu.
I want to thank my deputy and the chief administrative officer for supporting this function and giving our brother an honorable send-off.
Enemy for your enemy district manager, Gere Maguru district, Gere, Kirme Diu Ching, Kirme Chiling, Gengine Ame, Roma Roma, Chiling, Million, Apawe Beach.
Let me underline a few things that I believe are important for this occasion.
Though when I work, we give me more than time to get table. Pick up your man, pick up me. When I can do yak, I tip in, I get on when you work.
If you are standing far from a tree, you can actually think you are the same height with the tree.
Hey, chung kama bo, kia, wale kala tamani, ini don, may roba roba kia, kanuni.
Today you know a height, or let me say, altitude of Colonel Walter Ochora.
Chini, mawa kuwa reka indi, unwa tika ni anu bu, kala diru Ochora, Walter.
Secondly, we must believe that human beings can improve themselves by their own efforts.
Me ario, umeroge, ni wanchalo dana dana, ke roma wati kwe taro miwa kare, me rocho kuwa ni me meto kuwa yumebe.
He continued to study, he died while still a student. He believed in continuous self-improvement.
Lie liu medeke kwan, utoma uruti latin kwan, ada lele no gani enter down numero metiti numu ni yuma kaka.
I want to thank God for giving us Colonel Walter Ochora.
And me the four of us, the minimum meet, Colonel Walter Ochora, maru tinti yuma ni.
I also want to thank our mother, Mrs. Egeria Odoch.
And me the four of me gumatit. Min otalele Odoch, ma enye Egeria Odoch, ma na anu loko barukani, ma enye mama pa liye.
When have you ever attended the funeral where the mourners are instead comforted by the bereaved?
I will go up my initial chant more. May no ni otto ene daktika jingo chui lukumu.
Our mother has shown that her faith in God is shining through even in grief.
Megi wama dip unyuru kamaleng ni chwa keo nyo gemle kumle chwech ene tika jingu chunye wama ene tika jingu chunye kanyi wai kumirin.
She came to give thanks, not to lament.
Ene biyo ka foyo le chwech pega bako doge.
In her, you know the rewards of being a believer in God.
Dung maati bore nyo gimna ene wadyo indong in May mo gutam me pe lupoko la tweet ngayo ni pe pa lupoko la tweet kilo di ba kamero.
Colonel Walter Ochora was my political opponent, not my enemy.
Ladit ni le Colonel Walter Ochora yin ni kwere chalo mo no gichu me na kitu bibie kama papa endo no yin pelu mo.
In the same way that the football clubs of the world are not enemies, boxers are not enemies, we politicians should also not be personal enemies.
We be peche kama dega dega tiye ofero charu tubu dilu tubu bun tubu moye gani mapata kumi rokil moye.
Colonel Walter Ochora
can be generated after a reply.
When Colonel Ochora was appointed RDC, we worked together for all the time, and we took our people away from the camps, started the reconciliation process. We were truly reconciled. So I'm not included among those that are being forgiven by Colonel Ochora's mother. I was forgiven by Colonel Ochora himself. Colonel Walter Ochora knew those of us who were his political opponents. But I pity those who pretended to be his political friends but sabotaged his career. Even in the Bible, Jesus condemned the Pharisees more than those who were great sinners but who repented when they saw the light.
Anyway, gina choya, ruba pe kalo jo magiti meni gina na gini choki altai ritual loy jo manubal.
Colonel Walter Ochora had a great sense of humor.
La dit you know la yung fin madit, la yung fin lang ritual.
In fact, one day we should just gather to recollect his humor.
Nirma ache gwaram yo robe wuri wa o madit. We gwi wa chapo ikita no la dit yomo ke ne chunywa ka chela che.
I remember when he was invited to open the swimming pool in Acholi Inn.
And we repo e karma lele kino kayapo kafang madit maga yomi hotel madira chel gulukani Acholi Inn.
And he said the swimming pool cannot be opened with speeches.
Sila dit to wajine kafang kage yamu kilo.
It is not open by cutting a tape and a ribbon.
Peke yamu kati uranyo.
Bare chested.
Sila dit to teach wajine kikorono.
And he said, no. And he dived in. You can only imagine the amount of water he displaced. Then he was floating on top of the swimming pool and he said, the pool is now officially open.
Uberga kwang mabiri wipi ga don lo ki wipi kama uberga kwang e ni tin ni do aya bu ka kwang
uir. I cannot imagine Guru without Colonel Walter Ochora.
Dong en ma chalo mo pe mer nemo. Guru la boy Colonel Walter Ochora kung be ma tin pe bor.
Today we still have you, but when you go away to your homes, we are going to start really missing him.
Tin ni wati wu ka chelo go go ya ma chan ti ga do yo yo ma nok yo ba wa nyero. En ga wa ketto go wen ka chelo chelo.
Finally,
may I give him?
Colonel Walter Ochora was not a political sycophant.
La dito you no en pechava mero wibie, the mirror me clapo wibie.
La dito no peru renega.
He was not a political sycophant.
Because many people, when they are talking to the head of state, they want to tell the head of state what they think the head of state wants to hear.
Yang pulda madunga getinga lokila dilobo no kemete ki wat kila dilobo ngo magi tamun la dilobo mero wat mero winyune yana pe ngo mero tine no mero ke wat.
Even when he was talking to us, his political associates, he told us the plain truth.
Kene mero no ero berga lokki gem taruma o gema no gipiem kete itul ma papa. Kano Walter Ochora no chui logada.
I remember one time a man called Major Kakoza Mutale showed up in Gulu here.
And we born in my chair, the did Major Mama Gulu Major Kakoza Mutale, Upiru Gulu Kai.
It was alleged that Major Mutale was very close to the president.
Unokiwado Gerani, the did no chop, the did Major Mutale no chop to Twilight Kiladindo.
That even generals salute him.
Because
of his assignment.
One day he
came here and he started arresting
people. He
even went to Buchoro and exhumed some graves.
Complaints reached
Colonel Walter Ochora.
Colonel
Walter Ochora, a strong believer in the current government.
La dit Colonel Walter Ochora, ma maro gamenta in the tutual.
He said, I'm going to solve this problem.
Wajikijo mukilo report any borani any chilo peron.
And he said, I'm not going to solve it by complaining to the president.
Colonel Walter Ochora wajini ente bi chubu pero eruni paga kosa mutare ni fitter ga kosa bor la dilo ni wacho loka ga kosa mutare bor la dilo.
Colonel Ochora went on radio.
China dit Colonel Walter Ochora ochere radio.
We heard him say,
"Gim no giwinu la dit Colonel Wajo."
That I've got reports that Colonel that Major Kakoza is harassing people, arresting people, and exhuming graves.
Don Colonel Walter Ochora ochere radio. Wajine ene no report. Machimo ni Kakoza mutale tika mapo down, tika furu down, tika gululiel.
Then he said, "It is 10 o'clock now." If by 11 o'clock Major Kakoza has not left Gulu,
then
the people of Gulu will know the difference between a major and a colonel.
They say Major Kakoza
fled Guru via Kitum Road.
He was only M. My William, Nick Kakoza Motel Rio Mouth, Punya Goya, Dipper, Lobo Yoko.
We have not heard from Major Kakoza here in a long time.
The Jacket in early Loka Kakoza Motel of Gip, Teleport Mugi Carnival.
He has been visiting other districts, but Guru has not been one of his destinations.
Kakoza Oberkalimu districts, Mukena and of Gulukai, here in Yoga Yoga.
Indeed, Colonel Walter Ochora, like I said yesterday, was like a sword.
Ada Lele Colonel Walter Ochora Oberunotaro Paraluchuan.
It depended on which end you touched. If you touched the blade, it cut you. If you touched the handle, it was comfortable to hold.
Para maga mano lobo kuera mayini guru. Ke mago lare nguli. Ke mago kama ke mago ye chi noli makane gobyon no.
On behalf of Gulu District Local Government.
Dongme aga district me guru.
I want to convey our condolence to the family, to the army, and to the entire nation.
Dongme na chalo kumune bot art, bot moon, ki Uganda owen.
Rest in peace, Colonel Walter Ochora.
You are a kikuch, Larima, Colonel Walter Ochora.
The President of Republic of Uganda, I welcome you in my village, very small village, but great man came from this village. Brother Walter painted three different pictures. One of them, he is a hero. He's a champion and a star. One day, we were complaining because there was a wizard, a night dancer. He used to come and torment people here. So they told him, he said, "Mommy, are you sure?" He said, "Mommy said, when we sleep at night, something just comes and presses down." So you know with him, he's fearless. So he said, "Okay, one escort sleep there and I will remain in the compound." That night, the witch doctor, this wizard came bewitching this family, and Walter ran with him and caught him just around there. And they brought him naked to the people. And I thought, Walter's gonna kill this man. Walter said, "No, now that we caught you and we know who you are, we release you." And that man was released. He forgave. He painted that picture of forgiveness. One day, four people planned to buy a gun, and they got a gun to kill him. But one of them, knowing the calamity that will come after murdering Walter, came and he said, "Look, there's a plan." Walter arrested this man alive, and the escort said, "What can we do with him?" He said, "Release the man. Now that we know him, he will do nothing." That is him. The last one, he said he was fighting somewhere. And after fighting for 4 days, did he eat? Then they arrested a young man. We call him, "Take this man a journey, give him food, and I'll come back." And afterward, he became one of the best bodyguard for Walter. Walter took him back to Kasese. And the people in Kasese said, "You are not a journey. You are not a journey." We buried Iria Mugisha long time in the family. He painted another picture. Forgive and forget and give peace another chance. Mr. President, Your Highness, I'm a pastor. I can't talk a normal talk. I call on the President and I call on all the leaders of the Republic of Uganda. Please, this message is forgive, love, and I tell the children people, turn away from gun and from fighting and turn to God. Attention and turn to education, and there will be peace. What I was gonna matter, this is the final one, I don't have time. The politician have time, but the pastor don't have time. Once I went to London, and he stayed with me and my wife. My wife is here, that is my queen, and this time. This is this. We were there, and I said, "Walter, I have a plan, and the plan is here." I said, "We want to bring alternative tech him good and Uganda. He said, what is it? I said, to turn cow dung into gas and to turn human remain, dung feces, into gas. He said, I like the human one. I said, why? He said, because there are so many. You have to be better. You have to be an island. You have to acquire primary school. So we have free product. And we love. And all the dear owners, our brother from Sudan, we are praying for peace. Peace has come. I asked us about it yesterday. You struggled with Mega FM through the different funding. And you brought Mega FM to Guno with the help of my brother. And now look at peace in Guno, but he died. He's not here anymore. And the chaplain said, where is Jesus? Preach to me. He brought peace, reconciliation. And when he was dying in grief, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. Mama, baby, call in me on me. Ododuto, Walter, Oto, don't look at the other. Baby, baby, my dad, go with that. Thank you.
Thank you. That is fantastic. We just want to welcome you today and want to honor you for the great love that you have shown to this family. Especially our dear brother, our father, our friend, retired Colonel Walter Ochoa. Walter Ochoa, he went through a lot of problems when Idi Amin, who was a dictator, brutally murdered our dad. I remember one day when the late Rodoy was a treasurer of Ashuri district, he went into to Gulo, there was a place called Bada, and he bought me a pair of suits, and he went to Kingdom. When he went to Kingdom to do...
Hallelujah, when he went to Kingdom.
I'm sorry. When he went to Kingdom to do his duty for the community,
when he went to Kingdom to do his duty, serving the children of God, he saw his body. One thing that I want to thank God so much for, His Excellency, President Yuen, who said we had all this thing, is that today we have the whole world of Chora, Akua here, politician, opposition leader, you know, and you know, even our dear brother from Sudan, SPA, we are so proud. We want to thank you. One thing that I want to say is that world that always construed, Sir Richard, let's always forgive. World that always go all the way to go and support other people. And we, me as his brother, we are talking, people will really understand. What is he doing for you? But one thing the brother is, he always tried to make sure that other people also are benefit from whatever, you know, with us. And, you know, everything that I know today, even through his death, as the brother would say, unless a corner of wheat fall and die on the ground, it will bite the law. I know the death of my dear brother. The time of the world of God is going to bring about peace. I believe even because the God is mourning him. People of London is mourning him. Even I received a condolence from the same arm of the President of America, Barack Obama, Mama Desia, who is one of my flock. He sent his condolence, and also Mama Jane, who is under the President of America. And therefore, they sent that condolence. So, what I'm talking about, not only honored by Uganda company, but also other people from other countries like Kenya, Sudan. So, today we are so people, we want to thank God. One thing that I'm appealing for is, let peace prevail. As you already know, I already said, let's forgive one another. Mom has already talked with people and because, you know, a lot of words, a lot of abusing language have been flying, not only, you know, in the life of one of God. Even we as his brother, who are not politicians, I am not a politician. Amen? I am not a politician. I am here for peace. I love everybody. Despite the fact that, you know, some of you are not even believe in what you believe. But one thing I want to let you know, the Bible says, for God so loved the world, that the gate is only the God's son. That whoever says, believe in him, should not pay but ask the time of life. When I was a soldier, many times people bring charm, they say, oh, so I want that you have this one. When they were even fighting, you know, your government, your excellency. Then you say, yes, one of these days, the NRA will kill him. But what I will turn to the side, say, no, I only trust in God. He was not only somebody who wanted us to vote, he believed that when you work honestly, it will happen. He was an honest man. A lot of, you know, by then there was a lot of office.
officers who I used to know. Sorry to pick on it, but I won't have to know anything. Today I'm so honored. I want to thank you for coming with us and signing that. May God bless you. If I sat here, I forgive him. Just give me 1 year. I forgive him. One day God asked me, my son Richard, have you forgiven him for killing your dad? I said, yes, I forgive him. And guess what? When I went to pray for somebody in the hospital, it was a new daughter who was a strong, you know, an unbeliever, and she gave her life to Jesus. That is what our family stands for, you know? We will continue to work with the other political opponent of current world of God, and we will love and want to make sure that peace prevails in Uganda. And I want to appeal to everyone who lives in Uganda, let peace prevail. Let us not excite any riot. Let us accept things as it is. Amen? God bless you. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you for this great opportunity. And as we mourn our dear brother, he was our guy. We will miss him a lot, even more than the politician, because some people will leave both today and forget about him. But we as the family, we are having a wound in our heart. May you heal us today. May you heal the children. Father, we cannot.